Hi everyone, I'm Furkan. I'm developing a football game with my game engine. In this video, I'll show you the new render technique for displaying 100 characters, a refreshing look with the new stadium environment, rendering grass blades on the field, and finally improved goal net simulation. From the last video, there was lots of feedback for the humanoid character model that states it's not looking good enough. Current visual fidelity is not at the level I want, but I believe it can be improved with enough effort. I'm also still testing the game with the stick figure players, so we might see them in the actual game, if the humanoid model fails. That being said, I continued to improve the humanoid character system for displaying multiple characters efficiently. That required a new instanced rendering system for the skeletal animations. I achieved the result by sending the animation data for each character to the GPU by using textures as buffers. That enabled rendering at least 100 of animated characters without sacrificing too much on the performance. The simple scene that I'm using almost never changed since the project started. I wanted to create a new look with a new stadium while working on the visual improvements. The new stadium can also be used directly in the game. Increasing the complexity of the scene required a new rendering system with geometry instancing. Geometry instancing enables rendering multiple instances of the same mesh with a single draw call. This drastically improves the rendering time, and a basic stadium generally consists of multiple instances of the same meshes. I created the stadium model in Blender while trying to make each part reusable. I also developed a simple level of detail system for rendering the lower detailed versions of the objects as they move away from the camera. After some texturing work, the stadium started to look fine, but it needs more level design work to improve its overall character. The next job was upgrading the goal net physics. The first implementation wasn't enough for both physical and visual accuracy. I started with improving physics. The collision response between ball and net was wrong. I gather information for proper collision response. While exploring, I found new and more robust continuous collision detection algorithms. New algorithms improved the collision detection, but resolution and response required more effort. I tried multiple ways but couldn't find any for an all-in-one solution. After countless attempts, I stop at some point that the result is enough for my use case. I also updated the textures and rendering style so the net can be viewed from a distance. Finally, the goal net is properly reacting to the ball and looks good enough to be used in the game. I looked into rendering 3D grass to increase the visual fidelity of the football field. There are lots of examples online for how to render grass blades. In my case, the grass blades don't need to interact with any outside force, they just need to exist as 3D geometry. I simply generated a single triangle for a single grass blade, and I draw thousands of them with instanced rendering for each visible chunk near the camera. I also added lighting to match visuals with the rest of the scene. This simple approach really satisfied me as it is. Overall, it's obviously not a realistic one, but it lies inside the image I'm looking for in this game. Crafting a game's design language is a complex challenge that requires moving beyond experimental approaches to a more structured creative process. To develop innovative solutions for such problems, valuable classes can be found on today's sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is the largest online learning community for creatives, with thousands of classes led by industry experts. With learning paths, curated, sequential class collections, you can dive deep and master specific skills, taking your career or hobbies to the next level. Skillshare offers a wide range of creative classes, from digital art and illustration to graphic design, animation, film, and productivity. For example, Esteban Gast's Six Techniques to Spark Original Ideas class teaches practical creativity tools that help generate fresh concepts consistently across any medium. The first 500 people to use my link in the description will receive a 1-month free trial of Skillshare. Get started today. So, I believe the game earned some character after these improvements. While the first playable version is approaching, this was a mandatory stop to improve the visuals. I'm already working on the passing shooting in general, and it's already looking promising. The current gameplay definitely feels something unique to me. Right now, in the final chapters, Goalkeeper will be added to the gameplay loop with its new improvements, and possibly we'll see the first version of Defending. I'm currently exploring how to release the game. For choosing the right distribution service, the default option looks like the Steam. I'm kind of thinking that the game should fund itself through sales, but it might fail due to overvalued price, incomplete gameplay, and low content density. So if you have any thoughts on how to release a game, or alternative distribution services and platforms, please let me know in the comments. There is still lots of work to do. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.